Hello friends, today we are going to consider the undercapitalization. It means that in this period we have to study the concept of undercapitalization, symptoms of the undercapitalization, causes of undercapitalization, effects of undercapitalization and remedies of undercapitalization. All these things we have to study in detail in today's period. Try to understand. Very simple topic is here. In the last period, we have considered overcapitalization, and exact opposite situation you will find in undercapitalization. Now, we have to study the concept. It means that in this concept also, we have to understand the undercapitalization is the reverse of overcapitalization. Try to understand. Undercapitalization is nothing but a reverse of overcapitalization. Generally, it is regarded equivalent to the inadequacy of the capital. It is regarded as equivalent of inadequacy of the capital or paucity of funds. But it is not to be mistaken for lack of funds. Try to understand. It is not to be mistaken for lack of funds. Okay, it is a condition. Undercapitalization is a condition when the real value of the corporation is more than the book value. Try to understand. Very simple condition is there. It is a condition when the real value of the corporation is more than the book value. Company is said to be undercapitalized when you can say this company is undercapitalized company, when its earning capacity is exceptionally high. Try to understand what is the symptom is here. Its earning capacity is exceptionally high, and if it is there, then you can say that this company is undercapitalized company. Try to understand how this company is there. Undercapitalized company, or what type of capitalization is there? Undercapitalization. Okay, try to understand. Then, what are the symptoms of undercapitalization? Those symptoms also we have to study in detail. First symptom you will find of the undercapitalized company, that is, company is prosperous and enjoys a surplus always and always. It means that definitely you will find there is a prospectus for such type of a company, and such company enjoys always and always surplus. Okay, this is the first symptom. Second symptom is also there, too little capital to conduct its business. Try to understand. It means that there is a too little capital for conduction of its business or to conduct its business. This is also another symptom of the undercapitalization. Then rate of earning. Try to understand. The rate of earning on the total capital employed is exceptionally high as compared to other companies. Try to understand. It means that the rate of earning is high. And what type of a highest rate is? Exceptionally high rate as compared to the other companies. And the another symptom you will find of the undercapitalized company, undercapitalized organization, that is, the market price of the shares of the company may be high. The market price of the shares of the company definitely may be high. And these are the symptoms we have to study about the undercapitalized company or symptoms of undercapitalization. Undercapitalization exists. Friends, listen carefully. Undercapitalization exists when a company earns substantial income to pay rich dividend on its equity shares. The real worth of the assets of the business exceeds their book value. Try to understand. When a corporation is earning an extraordinary large return on its outstanding stocks, it is said to be undercapitalized. When you can say it is said to be undercapitalized, it means that when a corporation is earning an extraordinarily large return on its outstanding stock, it is said to be undercapitalized. Okay, it means that you have to understand when any corporation is going to earn extraordinary large return on its outstanding stock, at that time you have to identify that that organization, that company is undercapitalized. Okay, it means that this meaning you have to understand clearly. Then we have to study what are the causes of undercapitalization. What are the different causes of undercapitalization? There are n number of causes of the undercapitalization are there. In this chart, I have mentioned 7 causes. How many causes are here? 7 causes in this chart I have mentioned. First cause is there, what is it? Underestimation of earning. What is it? Underestimation of earning. Sometimes, while drafting the financial plan, the earnings are estimated at a lower rate and the capitalization may be based on that estimate, but actually the earning proves to be higher than expected. Okay, this is the first cause. It means that underestimation of earnings, this is the first cause. Second cause is also given there, high efficiency. What is it? High efficiency, this is the second cause. A corporation may have optimally utilized its assets and enhanced its efficiency by exploiting the schemes of modernization and taking maximum advantages of earning opportunities. The profits being depends on the efficiency of the concern will increase, and accordingly the real value, try to understand, the real value of the corporation may exceed its book value. It means that how you can identify in this way. And what is the second cause? That is the second, what is high efficiency. It means that optimal utilization of assets, optimum utilization of assets and enhancing its efficiency by exploiting the schemes of modernization. This is the second cause of the undercapitalization. Next cause you have to understand, that is a conservative dividend policy. What is it? Conservative dividend policy. Some corporations, try to understand, some corporations adopt a sound conservative policy of distributing the corporate income. They create adequate reserves and flow back the profit. They create adequate reserves and flow back the profits. The results of such capital, the results of such policy, the results of such organization is reflected in high rate of earnings. What is the result? High rate of earning, that is the result, and increase in the real value of the company's share. It means that conservative dividend policy is also the cause for the undercapitalization. Try to understand. Then another cause is also given here, unforeseen increase in earning. Many corporations, try to understand, n number of corporations started during the depression find themselves to be undercapitalized in the period of recovery or boom period. Okay, in the period of recovery or boom, the earnings at such time may increase proportionally. Try to understand, the earnings at such time may increase proportionally more than an increase in the amount of capital employed. More than increase in the amount of capital employed. It means that such type of unforeseen increase in the earning, this is also another cause of the undercapitalization. Next cause we have to understand, overestimation of cost or overestimation of cost of capital. Overestimation cost of capital. The amount of capitalization is based on the historical cost theory. Which theory is there? Historical cost theory may have been underestimated. That theory, it means that the amount of capital may have been underestimated. The assets may be worth much more. Try to understand. The assets may be worth much more than their historical values, than their historic values appearing in the books of the accounts. It means that such type of a reason also you have to understand. The worth of assets are much more than their historic values. It means that their worth of asset is also going up and up and up. And their historical value is lower and lower and lower at that time. At that time also, you will find such a company is undercapitalized company. Okay? What is the reason? What is the reason? Overestimation of cost of capital. Okay? This is the reason. Then, another reason is also there. Another cause is also there. Speculation. It is possible that, try to understand, the corporation may have embarked upon speculative activities. Corporation may have embarked upon speculative activities and earned fabulous profit. Once the corporation succeeds in getting bumper profit from speculative activities, try to understand, once the corporation succeeds in getting bumper profits from speculative activities, it may continue to indulge in these successful activities. It means that such type of activities may be continued by the organization, and that company, that organization may earn additional profits. Try to understand. And this is also another cause for the undercapitalization. Then next cause is also given here, that is a taxation. If the government adopts a lenient taxation policy, reducing thereby the burden of the corporate taxes, companies have a good amount of surplus. Such surplus can be distributed in the form of dividends in liberal manner. And this is also the last reason, this is also the last cause of the undercapitalization. In this way, these are the different causes of undercapitalization. How many causes we have studied here? There are 7 causes. First cause is given there, underestimation of earning. Next cause is also there, high efficiency. Then third cause is also given there, conservative dividend policy. Fourth cause is also I have mentioned, I have explained here, unforeseen increase in earning. Okay, fifth cause is also there, overestimation of cost of capital. Sixth cause is also mentioned there, speculation, and the last, taxation. In this way, these are the different causes of undercapitalization. Now, what are the effects of undercapitalization? Those effects also we have to study. And those effects are on the company, on the shareholders, and on the society as a whole. On these three aspects, such type of effects you'll find. What are those three aspects? On company also, effect of undercapitalization is there. On shareholders are also there. And on society is also there. Now, what are the effects of undercapitalization on company? First effect you will find on company, it intensifies the degree of competition, which may have significant effect on the profit margin of undercapitalized company. The competition may become more intense due to the entry of new entrepreneurs in the same line of the business. This is the first effect. Then second effect is also there, high rate of earning. High rate of earning will invite more tax liability. This is also effect of the undercapitalization. It means that if your company is undercapitalized company at that time definitely you will find the rate of earning is higher than the others, and such type of a high rate of earning definitely invite more tax liabilities, and this is also the effect we have to understand. And that tax liability and intervention over these companies are tightened. Try to understand. This is the another effect of the company, another effect on the company of the undercapitalization. Next effect is also given there. The share prices of undercapitalized company. Try to understand. The share prices of undercapitalized company registered violent fluctuations and speculations, take undue advantage of this situation. Such type of undue advantage you'll find. It means that the share prices of undercapitalized company definitely you'll find the fluctuating prices, and speculations also take place. Okay, and this will affect on the company also. Another effect is also we have to understand. In view of excessive earning, labor may demand increase in the wage rate. Try to understand. Labor may demand increase in wage rate, and non-fulfillment of their demand, what will happen? It may cause unrest. If company is unable to fulfill such type of a demand, or if company did not fulfill that demand at that time, it may be cause for unrest and discontentment among the workers. This is also very bad effect on the company also. Try to understand. Then what is the effect on another effect is also there. Consumers feels that about such type of organization, about such type of a company, about such type of a sector, consumers definitely feel that company is earning more profit and may expect the price of the product to be lowered and quality of the product significantly improved. Their dissatisfaction is determinant to the interest of the company. It means that such type of expectations are also there about the company of the customers or consumers. Okay, and this also effect, this effect is also we have to understand. Okay, now the effects of undercapitalization on shareholders. What are the effects on shareholders? Those effects also we have to study. First effect is also there. The shareholders get high dividends. The shareholders always and always get high dividends, but quite irregularly. Okay, but it quite irregular. Try to understand. It means that there is irregularity of such type of a high dividend, and this is also effect. Then another effect is also there. The shareholders' investment in such companies appreciates phenomenally, and thus they are benefited. This is also another effect. It means that the shareholders' investment in such type of a company definitely appreciated. Okay, and such type of appreciation definitely converted into the benefits also. Okay, and this is also the another effect of the undercapitalization on the shareholders. Okay, then next effect is also there. Shareholders can obtain short-term loans against the security of their shares. Try to understand. Shareholders can obtain immediately, without any difficulty, without any wasting of time, short-term loans against the security of their shares. Because what is the reason is there? What is the cause is there? Because of high credit standing in the market. Because of high credit standing in the market, such type of short-term loan can be given by the institution immediately. And the last effect on the shareholders we have to understand, that is the government may impose, try to understand, the government may impose dividend tax on the shareholders. Whatever may be dividend shareholders are getting, on that amount of the dividend, government is going to impose the dividend tax in view of high rate of dividend. And this is also the another effect on the shareholders. Try to understand. Then another class is there about the effects of undercapitalization on society. What type of effects are there on the society of the undercapitalization? Those effects also we have to understand. First effect is there. Try to understand. Undercapitalization encourages new entrepreneurs to set up new ventures and encourages existing ones to expand. Such type of encouragement will be received by this society. What type of encouragement is there? To start, to encourage new entrepreneurs to set up new ventures and also encourages existing ones to expand their business, expand their organization. Okay, this is the first effect on the society. Then next effect is also we have to understand. It means that undercapitalization gives boost to industrial activities, leading to growth of the economy. This is also another effect on the society. Then the consumers are benefited as they get variety of the products at a cheaper rate. This is very important effect on the society, because at a cheap rate, at lower prices, quality product customers can get, quality product consumers can entertain, okay, consumers can enjoy also. Try to understand. It means that this effect is positive effect on the society, because lower prices and more quality product they can get. It means that quality product can be provided by the company in cheaper rate, and this is also effect on the society. And another effect is also there. Undercapitalization creates more employment opportunities to the unemployed people. This is also positive effect on the society. Try to understand. It means that these effects are positive effects on the society, because creation of employment opportunity, that is also golden opportunity to the unemployed people. Try to understand. Who are unemployed, they can get employment under this situation. That's why this is also the positive effect of the undercapitalization on the society. In this way, these are the different types of the effects on the different classes. It means that we have seen already the effects of undercapitalization on the company, on the shareholders, and on society. In this way, these are the effects of undercapitalization. Now, what type of remedy is also available? It means that remedy is for undercapitalization. It means that in order to cure the condition of the undercapitalization, friends, try to understand. In order to cure the condition of the undercapitalization, it is necessary on the part of the company to reorganize its capital structure. And such type of capital structure you have to reorganize in such way that the number of shares increases and earning per share is reduced. Number of shares increases and earning per share is reduced. It may be done by one or more of the following methods. Try to understand. It means that number of shares you have to increase. Try to understand. Number of shares you have to increase and earning per share should be reduced. And in this way, such type of remedies you can explain. It may be done by one or more of the following methods. There are following methods, different types of the methods I have mentioned here. First method is there, stock split up method. What is it? Stock split up method. It means that in this method also we have to understand, in order to reduce the effect of the undercapitalization, try to understand, in stock split up method, the stocks or share values or the stocks or shares should be split up into large number of shares and reduces the value of shares proportionately. The effect of split up is that the earning would be spread over the greater number of the shares and earning per share would be reduced substantially. This is the first method you have to understand. Then second method is also there, increase in par value of the stock. Because of large surplus, the corporation might offer the stockholders new stock for the old. the new stock to carry the higher par value. This would not reduce earning per share, but it would reduce the rate of earning per share. But this method is rarely used as it does not improve marketability and it is too radical to be adopted. It means that increase in par value of the stock, this is the second method of the decrease the intensity of the undercapitalization, to reduce the intensity of the undercapitalization. And third method is also used there, that is the issue of bonus shares. If the company has adequate surplus in the hands, when company is getting additional surplus at that time also, the whole or part of the surplus can be capitalized by issue of bonus shares. At that time, company can issue the bonus shares. With the issue of bonus shares, share capitalize or share capital will increase along the number of shares, but the surplus of company will get reduced by the amount of bonus shares, because the number of shares are increased and the amount of surplus definitely will be divided into increased shares. At that time, the amount of bonus shares, the amount of dividend definitely will be reduced. In consequence, the earning per share is automatically reduced. Try to understand. These are the three methods for what purpose these methods are used. These methods are used for curation of the condition of undercapitalization. Now we have to make comparison of the undercapitalization and overcapitalization. Overcapitalization leads to more strain on the financial structure. It is dangerous to the shareholders and society. Overcapitalization always and always dangerous to the shareholders and society. The shareholders of such company have to pay high price and sacrifice a lot. Okay. In case of undercapitalization, what is happening? In case of undercapitalization leads to competition, creates labor unrest and feelings amongst the consumers that they are being exploited. It means that this type of situation you will find in undercapitalization. What is it? Undercapitalization leads to competition, creates labor unrest and feelings amongst the consumers that they are exploited. Try to understand. Under or overcapitalization, try to understand. Under or overcapitalization should be discouraged. What should be done there? Under and overcapitalization should be discouraged, and each and every corporation should aim at fair capitalization. What type of capitalization should be there? Fair capitalization. In this way, we have studied the topic of, what is it? Undercapitalization. Okay. If any difficulty is there, you can visit at this site. My email ID also I have given there. In that email ID, you can make comments also. You can ask your questions also. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much.